Ang susunod na programa ay Rated G. Ito ay pwede sa lahat ng manonood.
Intramuros, or the World City, is one of the oldest districts of Manila, built on the south bank of the Pasig River around 1571. It was built by the Spaniards, more specifically by Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, and is bound on all sides by moats and thick, high walls with some over 6 meters high.
During World War II, Intramuros was used as a garrison and prison facility by the Japanese, but Allied bombings resulted in it, and other parts of Manila being severely damaged and destroyed. At the end of the war, the U.S. took charge of the city and filled in the moat to prevent disease.
For our first stop, the Fort Santiago.
Spanish fort, a palisaded structure of logs and earth, was destroyed not long after its establishment when in 1574, the Chinese pirate Lin Feng launched an almost successful siege of Manila. The Spanish army repelled the attack, but the effort in realization of its defects was rebuilt in stone.
Of December 29, 1896, in the confines of his cell at Fort Santiago, Manila, Jose Rizal wrote his farewell letter. Addressed to his beloved family, the letter reflects his deep sense of patriotism and his acknowledgement of the imminent end. Rizal's words convey a profound acceptance of his destiny. He expressed regret for leaving his family behind, but emphasized that his sacrifice was willingly made for the cause of freedom. His anticipation of impending death was coupled with a plea for his family to find solace in a greater purpose, the pursuit of liberty for the Philippines.
Here is a piece of Rizal's vertebrae where the bullet hit Rizal. A closer look at the piece of vertebrae reveals the crack or chip portion believed to be where the bullet from the firing squad hit him on December 30, 1986. This is the most important display here at the Rizal Shrine, as this object is a part of Rizal himself. His bones were washed with the waters of the Estero de Binondo, and the remains were then placed in an urn kept by Rizal's family.
Inside the Fort Santiago, our next step is ruin of the American barracks.
Today, we gather to reflect upon the remnants of a bygone era, the silent witnesses of history, the ruins of American barracks. These vestiges of the past stand as tangible reminders of the sacrifice and triumphs that shape our nation. As we explore these crumbling walls and weathered foundation, we step back in the time to an era when these barracks housed brave men and women who served their country with unwavering dedication. Whether it be the echoes of the World War II or the remnants of the Cold War outposts, each brick and beams carry tales of courage, camaraderie, and resilience.
Our last stop, Manila Cathedral.
we find ourselves in the awe-inspiring Manila Cathedral, a sanctuary that stands as a testament to the country's enduring faith. Let the grandeur of the sacred place unfold before your eyes. The Manila Cathedral is the most recent version of the long-standing Church of Manila, built from 1954 to 1958 under the supervision of Filipino architect Fernando H. Ocampo. After the previous structure was flattened in the Second World War, it's a masterpiece of architecture. The cathedral serves both as the prime basilica of the Philippines and the highest seat of the Archbishop in the country. Its final resting place for former prelates who have served the Archdiocese of Manila was also used as a venue for the Requiem Mass for former President of the Philippines, Corazon Aquino.
And that concludes our trip to Intramuros. Thank you for joining us.
Bye! Bye.